I'm Ashley St. John, assistant professor at the Emerging Infectious Diseases Signature Research Program at Duke NUS Medical School in Singapore. And I'm pleased to talk about my recent study, Immune Synapses Between Mast Cells and Gamma Delta T Cells Limit Viral Infection, published in the Journal of Clinical Investigation. The skin is the root of infection for many pathogens, and one of the most important cell types involved in recognizing invading pathogens in the skin is the mast cell. Mast cells are granulated cells that are distributed fairly evenly throughout the skin, where they also surround blood vessels. Some of the pathogens, like dengue virus, which we used in this study, trigger mast cell activation and degranulation, where all of these inflammatory mediators are quickly released from the cell. We started this project with the question of how mast cells are able to promote protection from viral infection in the skin. One of the first observations we made was that mast cells trigger the recruitment of many different subsets of T cells into the skin. And of those T cells that were recruited, the fastest responding were gamma delta T cells. We visualized the mast cells and gamma delta T cells at the site of infection, and we were extremely surprised to see that there were many indications that the cells were interacting with each other. As you can see on the left, in uninfected skin, there are mast cells that are not interacting with any gamma delta T cells. But on the right, in the dengue infected skin, you can see that mast cells and gamma delta T cells are really closely associated with each other and they're interacting physically. Looking closely, we could see that there was a strong polarization of the T cell receptor towards the mast cell. This suggested to us that mast cells are activating gamma delta T cells in a way that is through the T cell receptor, which is similar to activation by antigen presentation. The experiments we did to show the mechanism involved a series of co-culture experiments where we observed that activation was contact dependent and it was occurring through the gamma delta TCR. Eventually, we narrowed down the possible receptors on mast cells that could be activating gamma delta T cells and found that a non-classical antigen presenting molecule known as EPCR interacts specifically with the gamma delta TCR. To really confirm the importance of gamma delta T cells declaring infection, we also used mice that were genetically deficient in gamma delta T cells. As you can see in this key figure, after dengue infection, these mice had much higher levels of virus in the skin, showing that gamma delta T cells are important for early host defense against dengue. This data to us really emphasized the importance of cell communication during infection. Mast cells and gamma delta T cells are known to be resident in the skin, but we never knew that they could communicate with each other to help clear infections. As immunologists, we often think that the key communication between various immune cells occurs in lymph nodes, but this data showed that given the right signals, mast cells can serve as non-classical antigen-presenting cells within hours of infection, and that the process starts right at the site of infection in the skin. We hope that since most vaccines are delivered into the skin, this new knowledge may have implications for improving vaccines.